celebrating you today, celebrating all that you do, the contribution and the years of service, and also service excellence through our Pillar Awards program, the contribution that you provide each and every day to our patients, our visitors, and the community that we serve. Medicine really is a team sport. And through today's program, the recognition of your dedication and years of service, as well as service excellence, you'll see each member of our very important team be celebrated for their contribution that they give to our patients, our visitors, and the community at large. Thank you so much for all that you do.
I have been here 45 years. I did start off at Burbank Hospital, and I was there for 28 years, and I had started on maternity in 1971, so I do feel very fortunate that when the hospital merged, I was able to come and work maternity at the Lumister campus. I have had a lot of job satisfaction during the years working along with my co-workers. Occasionally, I do find I have a grandmother or a great-grandmother that comes and kind of pats me on the shoulder and say, I remember you when you delivered my son or daughter. So that really makes me feel good that yes, during the years, I was able to make a difference in someone's life. When I first started, before you could even go in a nursery, you had to scrub for 10 minutes, put a gown on and wear a hat. Now we come wearing just regular scrubs, and unless there's a baby that's on precaution or what have you, you don't need to gown and do a scrub. You need to like your job, and you need to go with the flow, how things are going. You come in, you do the best you can, and try to leave knowing that you did do the best you can. I have found what I had been looking for here at Health Alliance.
I've been here for 25 years, and I'm very happy with my job. I take care of people in their own homes, or in a nursing home, giving them personal care. They look forward to your coming in and giving them a shower or a sponge bath. For them, it's a big thing. They can't do it themselves. There are people that don't have family, they live alone. They need some assistance, and they need another face to talk to them, to be their friend.
We all come together and we pitch in money for the families for Christmas. We usually pick one family and we get stuff for that family. I had already done my shopping. I was done Christmas shopping, but on Black Friday, there was a Patriots game that night. And my husband was not too happy that we were going out on Black Friday. He came out with me shopping on Black Friday, and he's like, we're shopping for a random family that we don't know on Black Friday in the craziness, and we didn't need anything for ourselves. So she thought that was, she was like, what were you doing out on Black Friday? And I was like, because you can get more stuff. Like, you know, we can only raise so much money, so I wanted to be able to get more. So, and I also used to wrap at Macy's. So I wrapped all the presents like really, really nice, and I put like giant bows on them and made like big stacks of presents and then put like big bows all over them and wrapped them all up really nice. And so there was glitter all over. There's still glitter in my office, in my keyboard. There's glitter from Christmas wrapping. So yeah, I had a lot of presents. I love to give things. I don't even like to receive. Like, my husband's like, what do you want for Christmas? I'm like, nothing. I just want to give people stuff, because I really, like, the joy of giving makes me extremely happy. Everyone should try it. It makes you feel good. Natural high.
I got nominated for the Spirit Award, and I believe because I'm a patient advocate for all of the mental health here that come through Lumister ER. Unfortunately, because of all the changes in mental health, there isn't a lot of beds out there for people to go, and they end up coming through our ER. And not only just the mental health, homeless people, people with all kinds of mental health problems. And to contain people in a small room for days on end is very difficult. So, you know, we try to provide them with dignity, and you know, the simple thing of getting to like brush your teeth in the morning, get your medication, be able to talk to a family member, somebody sitting down talking to you, listening to you, always giving an update of what's going on, how much longer do you have to wait, because I do go over and above a lot of times. The other day there was a family that came in at 3 o'clock. I knew a lot of resources and things that I could help them in the last few minutes that I was there, and I was kind of over time. And somebody said, "Why are you still here?" I said, "I'm helping somebody." Within that half hour, because I could get a back line at Spectrum, he got an appointment at 5:30 Monday morning. I just knew that they felt relieved, because it's hard to find help out there because the waiting lists are long for mental health, for appointments, and you know, when parents are out there trying to help their kids, they come in here and, you know, so if you can give those few minutes and explain to people what their options are, because a lot of times they're misled because people don't know.
I was nominated for this award for, I think, responding to a very disastrous situation. There was several patients that came to the ER by ambulance, by the waiting room, that were all very critically ill. And at that time, I wasn't on duty, however, was available and came in and was able to kind of run one of the codes and help decompress the ER. So many of the patients got to where they needed to go.
When the team that was working in the emergency room that morning realized that they had more than one patient going to arrive within a short period of time, they knew that they needed more help than they had. It's not normal for them to have that kind of business at that time of day in the emergency room. And that volume of patients requiring that critical of care would exceed not only the staffing resources, but the equipment resources that we have stored in the emergency room. So the emergency room fought quick on their feet, and they called a code blue. And for those of us that are clinicians, we know that the emergency room never calls a code blue. They have what they need. On this day, they called a code blue, which to me and the other clinicians who responded meant that there was something very unusual going on in the emergency room.
So we ran right downstairs. We were down there within 30 seconds. And as I was walking down to the ER rather briskly, I was just going in through my head, you know, what we were going to do when we got down there, not knowing what we were going to see. But I didn't really think of it as anything other than a usual day. This is what, kind of what we do, and there are times when the patients, you never know what you're going to get when you wake up that morning, what's going to come through the door. So I thought it was starting out rather as a busy day, but not beyond the scope of what we've, you know, done in the past.
The staff in the emergency room performed amazingly that day. They got the help they needed. They treated every patient respectfully, quickly, and without delays. And we were able to get the patients out fast enough to get the care they needed that needed to get to UMass.
When Danny called me and told me I had been nominated, the first words out of my mouth was that I was humbled, and I am humbled. There's a lot of people who work here who work very, very hard. Home care is not an easy job. You're on your own. You make decisions, sometimes life-threatening decisions, to send them to the ER or not, dealing with some families who are not always appreciative of what we do. I've been working very hard in the past few years to bring in the business from the what we call the West team, which is west of Gardner area, because our competition up there is very strong. And I've been working very hard with the social workers in Quabbin Valley and Baldwinville Nursing Home and Haywood Rehab, and my numbers have been going up quite a bit. We've landed a very good contract for our hospice department at Baldwinville Nursing Home, and I believe that was much to be part of it. I'm very, very happy here. I hope to be able to work at least another 5 years if they'll have me.
Rick Cicino has worked at the Burbank Campus Laboratory now for over 3 years. He's made a wonderful improvement just with the turnaround times that we've had with our oncology CBCs. This laboratory was not set up to allow rapid testing by technologists, only because it was a laboratory that was built originally in 1972. It became very obvious that in order to reduce our turnaround time for oncology CBCs, that we'd have to revamp the way that the laboratory here is set up. Rick was absolutely critical in making suggestions and developing footpaths around the laboratory to allow us to decrease our turnaround time, our average turnaround time for a CBC, from 36 minutes in 2009 to between 14 and 16 minutes in 2013. That has just really improved our patient care for upstairs, and they are absolutely thrilled with Rick. He's always here, he's on time, he's dependable, he's an incredible technologist and an all-around great guy, and it's been my real pleasure to work with Rick over the last 3 years. The beneficiaries for this particular site, for this particular laboratory, are definitely our oncology patients and our oncologists, and I know that Sophia has mentioned numerous times that they love when Rick is here because they know they're going to get the turnaround time that they need in order to get their patients through and to be able to treat those patients successfully.
I believe they were nominated because of all they do to support everybody here at Health Alliance, both patients, visitors, and employees. We sort of work behind the scenes to try to make a seamless, invisible support so that all of our patients can be taken care of. We were dealing with two things at the same time, a huge blizzard and the MRI unit went down, so they couldn't see patients. So our HVAC guy and the rest of the engineering team worked with the MRI service technicians to try to troubleshoot why the MRI was down. And so the whole team was doing snow removal, helping patients and visitors. You were, as an employee, will go out and your car will be cleaned. They even do it for my car sometimes. And that happens regularly year after year after year after year. But in this particular snowstorm, not only were we clearing cars and helping patients, but we also helped to bring the MRI unit back up so they didn't have to cancel all their patients. I'm very proud of the whole staff. I really am. I'm very proud of them.
Thank you for your important role in fulfilling our system's mission, improving the health of the people of our diverse communities of Central New England. Each and every one of you has made significant contributions to Health Alliance by striving to provide the very best in supporting our pillars of excellence: finance, quality, growth, and people. Today, we also recognize extraordinary employees performing extraordinary work through the Pillar Awards. Congratulations to each and every one of you. This celebration is our way of thanking you for your dedication, service, and above all, your commitment to providing exceptional care to everyone in our community.